There isn't much else around where we live. We know how good things could be without us, because everything we leave behind thrives. One of the best examples is Chernobyl, where wildlife is returning to areas that were cordoned off after the 1984 nuclear reactor explosion. Of course, they have some genetic issues. However, because there are no humans, the ecosystem is thriving as it had not for the previous 50 years, when humans came in and built the cities and power plant. The voluntary human extinction movement was founded by Les Unite, a high school substitute teacher living in Portland, Oregon. According to Knight, the overwhelming majority of human societies have not lived in sustainable lifestyles, and efforts to live eco-friendly lifestyles do not affect the eventual destruction of the world and many of its non-human animals by the human existence. Voluntary human extinction is supported through preventing human misery and the extinction of other species. Knight notes that the expanding human population is threatening numerous species. The VHEMT is an environmental movement which asks for all persons to refrain from reproduction in order to induce the slow voluntary extinction of mankind. VHEMT favors human extinction primarily because it would avoid environmental destruction, according to the organization. According to the organization, reducing the human population would save a large proportion of human-caused misery. The organization typically cites the extinction of non-human species and the shortage of resources required by humans as evidence of the harm caused by human overpopulation. VHEMT, a U.S. activist who was involved in the U.S. environmental movement in the 1970s and later believed that extinction was the best answer to Earth's biosphere and mankind issues, was created in 1991. VHEMT is a global organization. Knight publishes and serves as its spokesman for the group's newsletter. While the group is marketed and represented at certain environmental events, it relies significantly on outside media coverage to communicate its message. Many people consider their program as unacceptably harsh, but agree with the idea of limiting the reproductive rate of human beings. Some journalists and scientists in response to VHEMT stated that people can establish sustainable lives or reduce their population to sustainable standards. Others argue the human desire of reproductive activity, regardless of the merits of the proposal, will avoid humanity's voluntary annihilation. Knight attributed to human overpopulation most of the risks facing the globe. Knight says that mankind is significantly more than Earth can cope, and that human beings voluntarily stop reproducing the best thing for Earth's ecology. He said people are incompatible with the biosphere, and that human existence is damaging the environment, and ultimately leads to human extinction. He doesn't want you to commit suicide. He does, however, want us to die out and stop having children, because unrelenting population growth is depleting the planet's resources and, well, ruining everything. Earth can only be saved once it is free of humans. It's really that simple, even if it is a little frightening. His logic is cold, even brutal, but it is also undeniable on some levels. Knight is correct in stating that CO2 emissions have reached their highest point since the evolution of animals. This means that animal extinction is a cataclysmic threat. Knight sees a bleak future for all of us, with the unprojecting that the global population will reach 10 billion by 2050. A billion people are hungry right now, so how are we going to adequately care for everyone if we continue towards 10 billion? I think it's going to be really an unfortunate situation, he says. Thank you for watching Unfolding Saga.